Unique insight into doing business in Africa. Investment opportunity. Industry updates. Africa Business Radio, towards a profitable Africa.
Welcome back, and as promised, Sam De Freitas is here with us from Lisacars. How are you, Sam?
I'm very well, thank you. Good evening, and good evening to all your listeners.
Okay, so how was your experience in there?
It was great. I think there was a very varied bunch of speakers, and they certainly came out with different aspects about what it is to be successful.
You've been in business for quite some time, right?
Yeah, I'm not exactly a young entrepreneur, but I'm still an entrepreneur at heart, and I think you're only as young as your heart feels.
Yeah. So did you learn anything new, or do you already know all of that stuff and you've gone through it?
I think there were some different takes on what I've been doing for quite a while, but I think the message is the same. It's to be try and be positive. Whatever happens in your life, to try and be positive and take ownership of what's going on in your life.
Mm. So how long has Lisacars been around?
Well, Lisacars itself has been around a very short while as a new brand, a couple of months. But the actual Lisabank brand has been around since 1969. Not my age, by the way. But I think that a lot of people know the name Lisabank. But of course, because of the bank connotation, it made sense for us to actually tell people what we do, which is we're in the car business. We sell cars, something quite mundane, quite simple, and quite aspirational for a lot of people in South Africa.
Okay, and when it was started in 1969, it was based here in South Africa?
It was. The name Lisa is not a woman's name, although it sounds like one. It actually stands for Lisbon, South Africa, Bank.
Oh.
But we're not a bank. Let me put that up out there
exactly. Immediately.
Lisacars is basically our brand, Lisbon, South Africa Cars. More about who we are and where we are and what we do. Lisbon, South Africa, and motor cars.
So somebody would ask, why would you choose to come and start a business in Africa when you are from a much more developed economy?
Well, for myself, it was quite simple. I arrived here in 1964. So I've been here as long as I can remember. And starting a business for me was always something that as a foreigner, we had to. We arrived in 1964 and we were not exactly in power, if I can use that terminology.
Mm-hmm.
We had to make our way in South Africa. We had to start something in order to get somewhere in life. And I think we're pretty much in the same position today. Even South Africans today, unless they do something with their life, they're not going to get anywhere. You know, being employed today is maybe for many people no longer enough. You have to be self-employed in order to grow.
Yeah. And how has been your experience growing the business, especially within a country that has gone through so many changes over the last few years?
I must use the word unbelievable.
Mm.
You know, Lisabank itself, in terms of the car business, only been going about 8 years. And when I started by myself with one African girl, lady, I suppose, because she was in her 20s. And she used to help me do everything in the beginning. Eventually, she became a manager. Her name was Violet. And today, she's a manager somewhere in one of the other car businesses she moved on. So what I try and do is I try and employ as many people as possible. I think one of South Africa's biggest problems is not having enough employment. So Lisacars is at all times looking for young people who want to make a career in the motor industry.
Awesome. And what would be the best advice you would give to a young entrepreneur starting up right now?
Some experience. You know, life is about knowing something. And if you want to start something of your own, go into that industry, get a job in that industry, learn what the basics are, and once you have a little bit of inside knowledge, then by all means try and go out on your own, because to break or to reinvent the wheel is very difficult today. Get some experience.
Fantastic. Thank you so much for joining us, Sam. That was really, really fun.
Thank you very much.
All right, so we're going to take a short break. We might speak to some more entrepreneurs, but if we don't, we're definitely going to be posting up all the conversations that we've had today up on the website www.africabusinessradio.com. So stay tuned right here to get some more knowledge and insight from entrepreneurs who've been doing it for a long time. Like you heard from Sam, he's been around since 1969, so he knows what it takes to be successful in business. So stay tuned and we'll be right back.
Africa Business Radio, your one-stop resource platform for all things business news, economy, leadership, productivity, investment, and more. ABR, towards a profitable Africa.